we release a greenhouse gas called carbon dioxide or CO2 into the atmosphere by burning coal, by using our cars, using electricity. And naturally, the forests and the terrestrial component of the world in the oceans will pull in 50% of this CO2 that we release. So my job is trying to understand what is the role of forests in the future, how it will change in a changing climate, and also how forests will help regulate our climate in the future. I'm Dr. Jennifer Holm. I'm an earth system scientist and also a terrestrial ecologist, and I work at the Lawrence Berkeley National Lab. I work on a climate change model to try to understand how terrestrial ecosystems, and in particular forests and tropical rainforests, how they'll change in the future as a result of a changing climate. Climate models are global models using a lot of different mathematical equations. They do simulate the entire globe and all the very complex interactions between the atmosphere, the ocean, the land. So to be able to understand how future changes in the climate might affect the temperature or precipitation, we run things called scenarios. So we'll run a certain scenario of CO2 out into the future and then see how that might affect things like sea surface temperatures, precipitation over forests, different temperatures in different parts of the world, how it might affect ice melting or glaciers melting. And these are all the climate change projections that we'll use to try to help understand our future world. So to be able to run these cutting-edge climate models at very high resolutions, we use the resources of supercomputers. So here we're at the National Energy Research Scientific Computing Center, also called NERSC, and there are two main supercomputers that I use here for my work. These supercomputers are high-performancing computers that will use multiple processors at the same time. So essentially, it could be like running 10,000 or more or 100,000 of your laptops. So we need these higher computing resources to be able to look at these complex interactions. The majority of my work working with climate models is looking at the outputs and synthesizing and analyzing outputs and making figures and diagrams to then report to the scientific community. And I also work with a great diverse group of people, so we will have lots of meetings and presentations to try to collaborate and learn from each other. So what initially got me interested in my job was a high school teacher. I had an AP Environmental Science high school teacher that really, really opened my eyes to studying the environment. I then continued to get a Bachelor of Science. After that, and also through getting my master's and getting my PhD, I did a lot of field work, which was very, very interesting and made me learn a lot about the world around me. But then I started to realize to be able to look at very, very large regions, like say the entire Amazon forest or the entire boreal forest, and to be able to understand how environments change into the future, I understood that modeling was a very good tool. My advice to somebody who is looking to go into environmental sciences or to be in earth system sciences is always to keep asking questions. Every day I feel like I am pushed to the edge of my boundaries or pushed to think outside of the box, which is a very good thing. We are solving these problems because they are problems. And it could be very rewarding to understand how the planet is evolving and changing over time and how to make it a sustainable world for us in the future.